completing the square, find the corners of the turning point of the curve. So we're going to complete the square on this. So we're going to complete the square. So we remember that completing the square is going to have something like this. And we find half of this linear coefficient. So half of plus 10 is plus 5. So over here, let's have a little think. If I had x plus 5 all squared, I'm going to have x squared plus 5x plus 5x. Remember, it's a double bracket. And then I'm going to get plus 25 in the end. Okay? I only want plus 18 in the end. So this is going to give me plus 25. So I'm going to have to take 7 off this to get me back to 18. Okay? So that's a completed square form. But we need to use that to help us to find the turning point. So, I want the turning point is really the minimum point. So the minimum value here, I want the minimum value of y, so I want a minimum answer overall. So the minimum answer is a minimum when this bracket disappears. Because this bracket can only be 0 or positive, because it's squared. Whatever values of x we put in here, it's either going to be 0 or it's going to be positive. If we want the smallest answer overall, we want this answer to be the smallest possible thing when we take 7 off. So, when x is minus 5, that's the only way to get rid of this bracket to be 0, so that's the minimum. So when x is minus 5, and when x is minus 5, this is 0, y is going to be whatever this bit is left over on the end, but the same sign, minus 7. So there's our minimum point, minus 5, minus 7.